swell that comes through Hakai. It's breaking down all along the beach here, and that's going to be one of our concerns, is whether we can stay in there, what the surge is going to be like, as well as it being shallow. It shows only a couple of fathoms of water up in there, and we're hoping once we T-bone the one barge to the other, that it's going to work there. But we're waiting about it. In about an hour and a half, there's going to be a marine biologist show up, and Bruce McDonald is Cloud, I think his name is there, is going to be here to give us some instructions, and then we'll have a look at it. So we'll see how it goes from here. Well, we're looking into the river, and you can see the swell. There's the entrance here. Up in there and behind the rock. Hopefully there's enough bite in there so the swell won't create any surge. We'll find out in a while here. Quite cool, blowing offshore right now, so that's a good for us in any case. And we're gonna look up into the bay here. It's just after high water in the morning. November the 28th, and it's 8 o'clock. swell's gone down a fair amount. We're just inside the bay here, and you can see the camp there. That's the site right there. There's still quite a lot of surge on the beach, and I'm a little nervous about putting the barge up there at this time. With the forecast is so bad, it could just be pounding in here 6 feet high again, just no problem at all. Anyway, you can see the where she's running up on the beach there. I'm nervous about it being T-boned in the swell, one barge against the other, if buckling some plates or something like that. Out the wheelhouse windows, we're still at McCluskey Bay here, and barges are all secure, machinery all ready to go, just have to get some darn logs to alongside. That's what we're up to. That's the whole story.
Filled up with logs, and then up there we get that rope off, right? Should put it on the side, please.
Well, we'll have to tell them to make sure that it's clear. We'll have a look at that. You can see it's 8 o'clock in the morning on the 29th. We put the barge in. Sandy beach, breaking up on the beach here. The odd rock around. The guys up on the beach there, they're getting some lines prepared to put out on the outer corners of the barge. And they've got a wire up to the port hand corner there, gonna move it into the bulkhead. This looks a little dicey. I don't know if this loading logs on this barge is gonna work here. It seems to be a little shallow. Let's see how it goes. Give every bit of cooperation we can. I'm just gonna pan around here. The bay here. And there she is outside. It's quite a difference from what it was yesterday. It's blowing a southeast storm out there, and I guess it's knocking all the westerly swell down. Still a surge coming through Hakai Pass, and come around and look up in the river there. It's a sandbar. It's got a beautiful beach in here. Nice spot. And a photograph of the mate's head there. Come around. Boy, they've got that one line up on the corner there now. Pulling up snack. Anyway, they're going to try and load the barge with logs and move it out to the log barge. We're going to anchor around the corner in Rock Bay. This is totally unsuitable for trying to T-bone one against the other. It would just be an accident here, sure as hell. So we'll, the story goes on. Well, we're now pushing on the tail end of the barge and wheelhouse. We're sort of back today, darn. We're pretty well geared up. They're organizing a wire over there on the beach. Come across this corner of the barge. But even this nice day, you can see there's a surge in here moving things around. not the spot for the log barge. Low water, there's only 6 feet or less of water, depending on the tide, I guess. By the time we had 500 meters on the barge, we'd be aground. The first 25% of the barge takes it down to about 8 or 9 feet immediately, so we can't have it bouncing on the bottom in here. This wouldn't have a barge anymore. Anyway, we're going to make sure this barge is secure. Go down and move our log barge up to Rock Bay or someplace. It's only 4 miles away, and I guess we're going to trundle logs out on this barge to the log barge until it's done. There's the load. See it stretching on up, go up the hill there. Well, it's going to be an interesting experience. I think that the concept is good. I think it's just the beach and the weather conditions here that it's too darn shallow. Oh heck. We're looking down into Namu. We're going to be going into Rock Bay, which is just down in behind the island there. It's blowing about 30 or 35 here southeast. We've got the log barge behind us. We're going to put it in Rock Bay for security, and it's 4.5 miles from the log loading site, and about 6.5 miles closer than the other spot we were tied. There's a look back at the log barge through all those raindrops. Well, we're in Rock Bay. Philip's running a line ashore for the tail end of the barge to tie it up to the rocks up there. Blowing a big gale outside, and we're gonna secure in here now. We're out of the weather. Grab that wire over there. We're running out of Namu and down towards where our barge is tied. We had a report this morning at 6:30 that it was just pounded in there. We're pounding our way down there. We're having a time getting there ourselves. He wants to try and get the barge out of the bay there after all the assurances that we had that there'd be no problem there. We are. Don't know if we can really even do anything. Just have to go down and see how it goes. Well, here we are some hours later. We've got our barge out of the bay and through some surf, I must say. And we're transferring logs from the transport 2 to the 701. Weather conditions were real bad. Their swell conditions were such that they couldn't load any more logs on the T2 here, but it'll take a fair whack more. I think if they would have had the time, they could have had a good load.